Welcome back, friends. Our topic is graph of derivative of a function, that is the gradient function. From the last video, we found what dy dx or f dash x was. Actually, f dash x is the derivative of fx, which is the slope of the function at a given point in the domain of the function. Okay, let us consider that this is our function y is equal to fx. So friends, now we shall sketch a rough sketch of the graph of f dash x, which is the gradient function. This graph will be made by joining the values of the slopes of the given function. Okay friends, from this function y is equal to fx, we say that on this graph there are infinite number of points. Okay, and in each point we can draw a tangent. Now in this function we see that there are ups and hills. So at the upper part of this graph, say on this top, we can draw a tangent which is actually parallel to x-axis, isn't it? So since this tangent line is parallel to x-axis, so the slope of this line is equal to 0. So we can write this is m is equal to 0. The slope is 0. Again, here in this point also, friend, if we draw a tangent here, this tangent line will be parallel to x-axis. So the slope is again 0. Friends, this point, that is at this point also, we can draw a tangent line which is again parallel to x-axis. We can write m is equal to 0. This point also, that tangent is parallel to x-axis. For this, the slope is here also 0. So friends, in how many points we are getting the tangents are parallel to x-axis? 1, 2, 3 and 4. That means in these positions the values of the tangents is equal to 0. So when we shall draw the graph of f dash x, then we shall find that the graph of f dash x will cut the x-axis at the points where the slopes are equal to 0. Friends, we draw some vertical lines from this point, say this point is cutting the x-axis here, and from this point we draw a vertical. This is here. From this point also we are drawing the vertical which is cutting the x-axis here, and also from this point the vertical is here. Now friends, here the slope of this curve is equal to 0, so the curve of f dash x will pass through these 4 points. Now friends, remaining parts, this x-axis is divided into several parts, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. That means the curve is the original curve, that means fx is also divided into 5 parts. Before that, on the left side of this point, here in this graph, you see that whenever you draw any tangent line, the slope will be positive, isn't it? Consider that this point, we draw a tangent here, the slope of this tangent is positive, because if you extend this, this will make a positive acute angle with the positive direction of x-axis. For this, the slope of this tangent line is always positive. That means from here to here, you see that the slope of these tangents, wherever you draw a tangent, the slopes of the tangents are always positive from this part to this part. So we can take positive sign here, okay, positive. Now from this part to this part, okay, this part, you see that wherever you draw a tangent, suppose this, let us consider this point, if you draw a tangent here, this tangent is making an obtuse angle with the positive direction of x-axis. For this, the measure of this slope of this tangent is negative. Okay, from this point to this point, okay, wherever you draw any tangent, the slopes are always negative. For this, we mark it here a negative sign. Okay, from this point to this point on the parent graph, you see that wherever you draw any tangent, say here you can draw a tangent. This tangent is making an acute angle, an acute angle with the positive direction of x-axis. For this, slope is positive. So from this one to this point, it is always positive. The slopes are always positive, and this is an increasing curve. Okay, when the curve is increasing, the slopes are positive. That is, dy dx is positive, or f dash x is positive. Now take the point from this point to this point. The parent function is this one. Okay, again you see that this function is decreasing. So in the decreasing mode, if you draw any tangent, suppose you take this point and you draw a tangent line here. This tangent line again making an obtuse angle with the positive direction of x-axis. Okay, so that the measure of this slope is negative. For this, from this point to this point on this parent graph, the measures of slopes are negative. For this, we mark it here negative sign. Now on the right side of this point, that means on the parent graph, this is again the increasing part of this graph. On the graph of this part, on the right side of this part, you take any point and draw a tangent. This tangent will make acute angle with the positive direction of x-axis. For this, slopes are always positive. So in this part, the slopes are positive. So we mark it here positive. Okay, now we can draw the graph of f dash x. In between these two points, the curve will be negative. That means in this way, and from this point to this point, this is positive. So we draw like this way, and here negative. So we draw this way, and the remaining part is positive. For this, it will go upward direction. Here also, on the left side of this point, this is again going to the positive direction. Okay, so this is actually the rough sketch of f dash x. This is the parent function fx, y is equal to fx, and this is the function y is equal to f dash x, that is y dash is equal to f dash x. And this is the f dash x. This is the rough sketch of f dash x. Here friend, one thing I want to mention here, you see that in this part of this graph, at this point the slope of the tangent function will be maximum. For this point is actually most negative. Okay, and on this part we see that if we take a point here and the tangent makes the maximum positive value, for this is the maximum positive part on the f dash x curve. Okay, in this way the other parts also drawn. Now we shall draw another gradient function of this given function y is equal to fx. Now friends, first of all, f dash x does not exist in sharp points. Here we see that there are sharp points, so in these points we cannot draw tangents. Or f dash x does not exist in break or hole in fx. There is no break or holes in this function. Or f dash x does not exist when the tangent is perpendicular on x-axis. Here also we shall not get any tangent line which will be perpendicular on x-axis. Okay, now first of all friends, from -3 to -2 on this piece, which we get that whenever we take any point on this line, the tangent line will be again this line. Okay, for this, the slope of this line is always positive. M is equal to 1, because you see that this point is actually 1, the height is 1 unit, and the distance between -3 and -2 is 1 unit, and this height is 1 unit. This makes 45 degree with the positive direction of x-axis, for the slope is 1 unit. Okay, and this is positive. And this line, this part, is making 135 degree with the positive direction of x-axis, for this and the slope is equal to minus 1. Similarly, this is 1, this is minus 1, this is 1, this one is minus 1. Okay, so friends, on these curves, that means on the sharp points, we cannot draw any tangent, but except these points, we can draw the tangents on these curves, and the curves will be coincident on with these lines, the piece of lines. Now we shall draw the graph of f dash x. Friends, from minus 3 to minus 2, the slope is 1. At each point, the slope is 1. For this, we have to draw the curve 1 unit above on this x-axis, and this is remains 1 unit, and the curve will be, the graph will be like this one. The height is always 1. The height is always 1, except minus 3 and minus 2, because at minus 3 and minus 2, you cannot draw any tangent. Okay, except those two points, we can draw a tangent, and the measure of the slopes will be always 1 unit. For this, the height is 1 unit. From minus 2 to minus 1, in this graph, minus 2 to minus 1, the slope is negative 1. So we draw this like this way. This is minus 1 unit below this x-axis. And from 1 to minus 1 to 0, see that minus 1 to 0, the slope of this line, this piece, is 1 unit. For this, again, we draw positive part. This is 1 unit. But at minus 1 and at 0, we cannot draw any tangent. For this, we have circled here, white circled. From 0 to 1, okay, from 0 to 1, the slope is negative 1. For this, we have to draw negatives on the negative side. And from 1 to 2, the slope is 1 unit. For this, we take the positive part of this graph. From 2 to 3, similarly, we see that the slope is minus 1 at each point. So for this, it remains minus 1 unit on this, in between these two points, 2 and 3. But at 2 and 3, we cannot draw any tangent line. So for this, we have discarded these two points, 2 and 3. So this is the graph of y is equal to f dash x, and this one is the graph of y is equal to fx. In this way, you can draw many more gradient functions. Thank you. Have a nice day.